Today, one of our listeners asked us to prank his wife.
Ooh.
They own a small motel together.
Oh, gosh. Oh.
She works the front desk answering all the phone calls, and she's told her husband multiple times she does not like awkward situations or confrontations with customers.
Uh-oh.
Which is why, per the husband's request, we're going to make this phone call as uncomfortable as humanly possible for her in your phone tab right now.
Thank you for calling Lake Motel. This is Louise.
Hi, I think my girlfriend is cheating on me right now in one of your motel rooms. Hello?
Hi, I'm sorry?
My girlfriend told me that she was going out to get her hair done, but we share our locations on our phones and it says that she's at your motel right now.
Okay, I'm really sorry to hear that.
Me too. Did a blonde woman check in today looking like suspiciously happy, like she was going to pull one over on her boyfriend, and there was just that look in her eyes?
Look, you seem like a nice person.
Can you just check if she rented a room there? Her name's Renee Fulmont.
Okay.
Sometimes she wears a hat, and it should have the word sleep written that wraps all the way around the outside. Because that's what she does. She sleeps around. Around.
Oh my God.
Sorry. Have you ever cried so hard that you almost drowned in your own tears? I'm sorry. I'll get it together. It's Renee Fulmont. Just look that name up.
Fulmont?
Fulmont. Sometimes she uses fake names when she's sneaking around on me. She goes by the name Frida Livery.
Frida Livery, no.
Can you check it? There's no Frida Livery?
No, I would have remembered it.
Okay. Can you check Jenna Talia? She likes that one. She thinks it's funny.
No, we definitely didn't have anybody check in by that name.
Okay. I have about 20 more fake names that she likes to use.
Yeah.
Joanna Hand.
I don't have the time to go over all of these names. And you sound like a really nice guy. I'm sorry that...
I am a nice... Why do you think my girlfriend would cheat on me like this?
I mean, I don't know. Maybe talk to somebody about it.
I am talking to somebody, you.
Yeah, but like I manage this motel, so I'm not really...
Well, if you could just connect me to her room.
We don't have anybody by those names here, so I can't.
Maybe you could just transfer me to room by room. Just start at room 101, and I'll just talk to them.
We can't do that.
If that's not them, I'll go to room 102.
I can't just connect you to random because
I see how it is. You're on her side.
No, I'm just trying to run a business.
No, I get it. Girl code, sisters before misters.
Excuse me?
You probably just love having cheaters as guests over all the time. They're like your best customers, so why would you rat them out, right?
Sir, we rent rooms to customers. What they do in them is their business.
Maybe you should have like a questionnaire for customers that says, like, am I going to use this room for cheating?
Yeah, that is not going to happen. And
maybe they would recognize you on TripAdvisor as the number one motel in the world for infidelity.
Oh, my God.
And they'll probably even give you a plaque.
Okay, sir. Great suggestion. I will keep that in mind. Is there anything else I can do for you? Because I have to run.
Yeah, and I would like to talk to your husband, too. Your husband, Sam, please.
How do you know my husband's name?
Because he invited me to come over to the motel and spin a sign in the front that says, come cheat here.
What?
Best cheating in the world.
What?
Yeah. After I'm done doing this prank phone call on you, he's like, let's have all the cheating in this motel room.
Oh my God, I'm going to kill him.
Because I'm not... I'm really a radio host. My name's Jeff from the show Brooke and Jeffrey in the Morning. This is a prank call.
Oh my God. I'm so bad for you. I didn't even know what to say.
I know. You wouldn't listen to my list of 20 fake names that she goes by. I can't believe that.
You got me good.
Unibrow? Are you sure that that name's not on there anywhere?
Definitely not.